We're only got about a 150 down here. Two more feeding up from the bottom draw. The front one looks pretty good. But if we're looking back, I think it's my best bottom record. We're going to take a look at what this two guys did. And the deer are getting on their feet and coming out to feed.
He's going to smell us and go.
Nice buck right there. It's definitely a shooter. I gotta get a little closer. We're at 65. Let's try to close the gap. That deer got to 40 yards, giving kind of a hard cording away angle, but I buried it in there pretty tight. I think we're going to give him about 20, 30 minutes to go ahead and lay down. Came in front of his haunch, but it was hard into the lungs. I think I got him good. Let's just give him a little time and we'll go find him. Hey Keith, I found the arrow. That, right up that blood trail. Wow. That's how you get it done there. Look at that. Clean path through. There's more blood. Blood. Look. Look up there. There he is. Woo! Oh my goodness. Look at this deer. Look at him. Keith, look at this deer. Oh my God. That's my first mule deer ever. Awesome. Wow. Wow. We're up here at the Elk Ranch with Keith, and he put me on this nice deer. It's my first mule deer with a bow. I did actually mention one a couple of days ago, but a little bigger than this, but I'm real happy with this. He's just getting out of his velvet. About half of him got the velvet still. But he's a nice 5x3. Stocked up, got about 40 yards from him. A little cording away, but I put it right in the pocket. He went about, no more than 75 yards. He crashed up right here. Awful neat deer. My first mule deer. Pretty cool.